and he wasn't paying attention when he drove in here. Everybody on the boat heard a loud, and we no longer have our 6'8" captain, ladies and gentlemen. And yes, I just fit under there, I know. Now, the island on the right side here is Marriage Island. It averages one marriage there a day. I've already driven past two weddings today. Now, the structure that's on that island, that's for Father Massenet. He was the very first Catholic priest to ever bless our river. Again, that happened on June 13th, which is the feast day of San Antonio. But it was in 1691. Now, right where the boat is right now, 6 years ago when we drained the river, guess what we found in the mud? Well, we found a 3.65 square cut diamond ring right there. Now, if any of you ladies or gentlemen are going to tell me the ring is yours, first of all, I should tell you your ring is now, or at least it was last month, on display at our Chamber of Commerce. You have excellent taste. My wife and I saw it. It is a flawless pink diamond. It is gorgeous. I should remind you, there are initials and numbers inside that ring. You will have to remember the sequence. And I should better tell you, my four guesses were wrong. I only have one very serious question for you. And it's a very simple question. What were you thinking? Today, your ring is valued at over $75,000. And you threw it in the mud? I'd love to hear the story behind that one, wouldn't you? That's gotta be a darn good story. Now in front of us, all the way down that reddish colored building, that is the Bexar County Courthouse. That is the oldest, largest, continuously used courthouse in the entire state of Texas. We harvested sandstone and granite from our state to get it that coloring. The Tower Life building is the building on the left-hand side. It is 31 stories tall, of neo-Gothic architecture, and this was the tallest building in Texas for a long time. Now, if you notice at the very, very, very top of the building, there are gargoyles up there. Now, if you believe in Gothic mythology, the gargoyles are there to protect the building from evil. But if you don't buy that, then their other function is, when it rains, it actually diverts the water to the corners so it'll filter down here to the river. Now, just above the arch windows, all the way around the building, there are faces. Now, they, again, are called grotesque faces. And in Gothic mythology, their job is to scare away evil from the sides of the building. Personally, I think those faces still work. This one here on the end, every time I drive by her, I get nervous. Looks an awful lot like my mother-in-law. And you thought I was kidding when I said my jokes were bad. Now, as I said earlier, many of our buildings down here, they do have a history and a heritage. Now, another neat building that's got a history and heritage is coming up on the right side of the boat. This avocado green color building. This was our main public library for decades. Now, it's the International Center. It actually has trade offices in there for Canada, Mexico, and the United States. At street level, another nice restaurant for us. And the bottom, well, that's probably where I'm going to park the boat tonight. We have two marinas. That is one of them that we actively use. Now, I did mention our 9 floodgates. We're going to go through floodgate number 4. This one actually comes up and closes just like a drawbridge. The green light here tells me the floodgate is all the way open. When we drain our river, that is when we close it, ladies and gentlemen. But today is not that day. Now, because I'm pulling out into two-way traffic, I do honk the horn. I want to make darn sure I don't lose the front of the boat, but I also do that to make sure that the post of you are still awake. As I come around this curve, the river actually comes out of the horseshoe, out of that floodgate, and takes a left. It goes behind me, all the way down to the Guadalupe River, about 130 miles, another 10 miles. Now our river ends up in the Gulf of Mexico. The river starts 5 miles up in front of us. Comes up out of the ground from a giant underground lake. It's called Edwards Aquifer. Now that is the same place where all of us here in San Antonio get our water. So if you're from out of town and you watch our local news channels and they talk about the water level at Edwards, that is what they're talking about. Now all of this was drawn up on paper by a gentleman named Robert Huckman. I mentioned him earlier. He drew up plans for all 9 of our floodgates, and when the project was finally completed in 1941, nothing inside the horseshoe is flooded, ladies and gentlemen. Whether we have a lot of rain, or in case of last summer where we had very little rain, the water level pretty much stays right as you see it right now. Now just past this bridge on the right side, this is Drury Plaza. They were kind enough a couple years ago to donate 850 feet for the sidewalk. Since then, you can now walk the entire inside portion of our horseshoe at river level. And on the left-hand side, if you go up the stairs, well, that's Main Plaza. Used to be the exact center of our city. Now, San Fernando Cathedral's up there. That is one of the oldest cathedrals in our nation. And you'll find some nice restaurants. During the work week, there is live music up there as well. Now, in front of the boat, also about a mile and a half up, is where our museum reach section begins. We opened that up a year ago in May. If you're interested in going up that way, our river taxis, they can take you up there. They're the only boats that actually go up there. Or you can walk it. The sidewalk on the right side is handicapped accessible. The artwork up there is totally different and quite beautiful. The vegetation is different, and the lighting at night is totally different than downtown as well. It's a very beautiful walk and a very lovely ride, ladies and gentlemen. Now, right in front of the boat is, well, a cypress tree. Now, this cypress tree is over 9 stories tall, and that's one of the oldest trees down here on the river. This tree is well over 300 years old. Now, those are facts. Some say it's a fact, others say it's fiction, and I'll let you make the call on this one. It's been said during the siege of the Alamo, Santa Ana actually put men in that tree and shoot it. They were shooting our boys. See, the Alamo is about 700 yards in front of the boat. That is one heck of a shot with a musket. How would you decide if you think it's true or if it's false? Above your heads, this is floodgate number 3. Now this one, again, comes straight down like a garage door. When we drain our river, we do close them. Just today is not that day. And we're coming back into the horse side of the horseshoe, again about 3 feet deep here. And on the right side of the boat is something you may not have in your neighborhood back home. It is something just a little bit on the unusual side. Just past the sign and the awning, well, there's a tree right here. However, if you want to find the rest of that tree, you actually have to go inside the restaurant. That tree is growing right through the side of a solid wall. Now, some believe that was done from one of our previous floods. Others believe somebody did that as a practical joke. We're not sure exactly how it happened. We just know it's a live tree growing through the side of a solid wall. Again, it's something most people don't have in their neighborhood back home. Well, guys, this is where we started up there. But I drop you off back here because it's a little less congested. Thank you for letting me take you down the river. I have just 2 very simple requests. One, I need all of you to stay seated until I have the boat tied off. That's for my safety as well as yours. The other request, please take everything with you. I promise you, if you leave anything of value on the boat, you can buy it back next week from me on eBay. All proceeds, of course, go to my grandkids. You'd be surprised what gets left on the boat. I hope all of you have a great time and enjoy our city and enjoy our river. Again, stay seated for just a little bit longer. And for a job well done, our drivers do appreciate your tips.